Get ready to match the stars from Blockbusters, Bill Cullen, Brett Summers, Cheryl Nelson Riley, Jaron Farrell, McLean Stevenson, and Edie McClure as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Bravo, bravo.
Oh, look.
Everybody ready?
Oh, the picture.
What'd you say?
You're a vision in pink.
That's quite pink, isn't it?
Pink.
Yes, but aren't we all?
I like it.
Thank you.
By the polo.
All right, stars, would you join me in greeting our two players, Art Haberman and Norma Pettineau? Yay. Art, tell us about you again, please, quickly.
My name is Art Haberman. I'm originally from New York. I'm now in Pasadena Chiropractic College, and 16 weeks from now, I'll be a chiropractor.
All right. And Norma is a school teacher.
Yes.
She's 24 years old.
Single.
And she's unattached.
Yes.
And I think I'm in love. All right. Good luck to both of you where we are. Starting round two, he's ahead, so he has to go first.
B, please.
All right. Old Oscar, the cruise director, is really old. The first shuffleboard game he ever organized was on the blank.
Oh, that's nice.
You don't play.
I know it.
All right, Art, here we go. Old Oscar, the cruise director, is really old. The first shuffleboard game he ever organized was on the blank.
Titanic?
Oh. All right, I don't think that's going to do it for you. But we'll see. Bill?
Titanic was in 1912.
Right.
That's indeed old.
Well, there's some older than that.
The vessel I have in mind is.
It is? What do you have in mind, Bill?
The vessel I had in mind was back around 1720 or something. The Ark.
The Ark.
Hey, that's right.
40 days and 40 nights it rained.
Oh, and we still.
And that started the float. Yeah.
It was between the kangaroos versus the baboons. Baboons 17, kangaroos 8. Noah's Ark.
Right. It was a wonderful game, wasn't it? Exciting.
It was terrific.
Really old cruise director. First shuffleboard game he ever organized was on the...
I never was very religious, so I said the Titanic.
Now, wait a minute.
She don't play.
In the first round, my dear, you matched Art. So when it says don't write here... That means you don't play. It's not a mortal sin or anything like that. It's perfectly all right.
I'm sorry. She's not really.
Nice try.
Oh,
I know
I'm
you
sorry.
Want to help him. Right. All right. Hello, testing. 1, 2. Yes, here we are.
Hi there. Right. My answer is no bra. What was the question?
The first shuffleboard you ever organized was on the...
On the no bra. No. Yeah. Being a chauvinistic pig, and oh boy.
Where are you going to get it?
No. Really? No, he's not.
That's a great cast party. Well, I said Noah's Ark.
Noah's Ark seems to be the answer here.
Isn't that funny?
Is that the popular fave with you two?
Don't give up hope. I'm not old enough to remember the Ark. By the way, are the baboons or the kangaroos now in the playoffs? Do they get to go now? Is it the baboons or the kangaroos?
They're both
eliminated. And then a third round pick, and then there's a wild card, right?
Right. They were eliminated by the Jaguars.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I said the Titanic.
Good for you. Now, Norma, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Phil said this hamburger must be made out of horse meat. I can tell. On top of the bun, there's a little blank. All right, we're all set now. Phil said this hamburger must be made out of horse meat. I can tell. On top of the bun, there's a little blank.
Saddle?
Little saddle. Perfect. Wonderful answer.
What did she say?
She came up with a wonderful answer. A saddle.
Exactly.
That's
a wonderful answer.
The silliest thing I've ever heard of in my whole life. Why on earth would anyone say saddle?
Saddle it is. All right, 3-2 the score.
I'm sorry, sweetheart. I said horseshoe.
Horseshoe? Anything connected with a horse would be good here. A saddle is perfectly wonderful, I think, don't you?
Yes, I've got somebody on as a jockey.
Jockey. Uh-huh. Now, I have a feeling that McLean is going to say blinders, because horses wear blinders. Right,
no,
McLean?
No, I'm just trying to do this to save my marriage.
Well, you don't need this one.
Actually, I said jockey.
You said jockey. All right, now you've got to match Edie to achieve a tie, Norma, and stay in the game. What have you say? What have you got there?
Bye, Nora. Jockey.
All right, come on down, Art. Here we go. Big money at stake here for you, pal. Good luck to you. Big super match. We polled an audience and said, how about giving us a good answer to this? Hind blank. Hind blank.
I'll go with Charles. He's all right.
Charles?
Hind sight.
Hindsight.
McLean?
I'm going to say either hind end or hind quarter. I'm going to say hind quarter.
Hind quarter.
Brett? I'm going to say hind end.
Really?
Hind leg.
All right, so you've got hind end, hind sight, and hind quarters. Now, you can choose one of those. You may have a better one in your own mind that you want to give us.
I'm going to go with hindsight.
Hindsight. Let's see if we have hindsight up here. May we see the $100 one, please? Hind end is up there. He wants hindsight. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Hindsight it is. Congratulations to you. Hindsight. What do you think's on top there?
Next one.
One
leg. All right, go.
Leg
was up there on top. Now you got $250, means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $2,500. But of course, we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and go for $5,000.
Oh, sorry, dear.
That's all right, Brett.
Facing me, please. There okay. We go. Good luck to you. Here it is.
You call me Ed anytime. All right.
$2,500. This is it. Portrait of blank. Portrait of blank. Take a look at it. Just want to make sure that you understand what we're saying here. Your job is to match Edie. If you do that, you get $2,500. What do you say?
The only portion I think of Whistler's mother.
Whistler's mother. Portrait of Whistler's mother. Well, there are a number of good choices here. I guess that must be one. Okay, Eddie, baby.
Well, if you'll excuse me, you would not be a candidate for jumping on my bones as a chiropractor, you see, because we did not, I'm afraid, match, because I was thinking of the title, Portrait of Dorian Gray.
That was a famous motion picture and book. So, he ends up with a total of $250, and we're going to start game number two of his opponent in a moment or so, but first this for you. Now, let's go on. Welcome Norma Pettineau back here. And start game number two, the final game, Norma, A or B?
I'll take A, Gene.
Yes, ma'am. Al said.
Al.
Al.
My blind date said, she looks like Jane Russell. I just saw her in person. She looks more like blank Russell. There you go. Al said, my blind date said she looks like Jane Russell. I just saw her in person. She looks more like blank Russell.
I only think of Bill Russell.
Bill Russell is good. Bill Russell is a famous, wonderful basketball player and a great commentator in the sport, too.
Indeed. That's who I was thinking of.
Formerly of the Boston Celtics.
That's exactly right.
And a great commentator.
Yeah, oh, he's
and
wonderful.
And I couldn't think of his first name.
Oh.
I tried. I really did. I thought of Cassie Russell, who was also a basketball player.
Right.
But he's had...
So what'd you finally come up with?
You draw blanks. This is the dumbest answer in the... Ken. Ken Russell is a famous Ken. He's very well known. He's a director.
Yeah, friend of yours, right.
No. Personal he got it from me.
I looked over there and I said, who's Ken Russell? I don't know.
I said, well, Ken is
Ken.
Good on your life.
All right, I love Ken.
Between that mouth and this heavy hat, I hope I make it. Bill.
Bill Russell. Good. All right. My blind date said she looks like Jane Russell. I saw her in person. She looks more like...
Rosalind Russell. I'm sorry. That's a lady.
McLean.
Okay. This is going to sound even dumber than Bill's. But Lou Russell is Ken Russell's best friend. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, America. I truly am.
All right.
Oh, just how you feel, McLean.
There is a man who's really hot, because in the world of comedy, he rhymes a lot. Mr. Nipsey Russell.
Good one. Good one.
Why not?
All right. Here we go, Art. Ready. Lou said this airline has three classes.
Say what again? I'm sorry.
This airline has three classes.
Who said that?
Lou. The guy that, his friend, you
his
know.
Friend.
Lou. Friend. Brother of Ken Russell, Lou. Yeah. Lou Russell said
so
that.
They're flying now, right?
No.
Did you ever meet Manny Russell?
No.
He was over in China for a few days, but didn't stay too long.
No, the food didn't agree with him. He ran out of Lomatil. In first class, they give you a tablecloth and a steak dinner. In second class, they give you a paper napkin and a chicken dinner. In third class, they give you a rag and a blank. Run to Chuck, let's go. Lou said, this airline has three classes. In first class, they give you a tablecloth and a steak dinner. In second class, they give you a paper napkin and a chicken dinner. In third class, they give you a rag and a blank.
Glass of water.
Glass of water? That's really fasting. Glass of water, he says. What do you say to that?
Mine was a little classier than that, Gene. Sandwich, a rag and a down.
A rag and a sandwich, stream. That's okay.
Well, I said they give you a rag and a can of Campbell's tomato soup.
All right. Both of those are fine.
My people are.
A rag and a can of Alfo beef and liver.
Alfo beef and liver. That's really third class if I've ever heard it. In third class, they give you a rag and a what?
A bone.
A rag and a bone. Very good.
Oh, that's
enough. That's all right, but it's a wonderful answer. And I don't care if you never match. Just keep showing up.
Or showing.
Showing.
McLean.
Yo.
Would you like to get your own show, McLean?
No, I'm happy doing this.
Oh, all right.
Five sweaters and a pair of dirty pants, you can make pretty good money.
Right.
Anyway, let me give my answer, okay?
Good. Do your answer.
Okay, I said they give
third
you...
In third class...
Yes. Do you want to set it up to you?
In second class, a paper napkin, chicken dinner. In third class, I give you a rag and...
A picture of Lou Russell and a chicken wing.
All right. Come on, Edie McClurg. What do you say, baby?
A hank of hair, a rag, and a bone.
There it is. That's the answer. Well done, ladies. All right, we go to round two. Norma, you're ahead 1-0. Isn't this a tight game? You go first.
I'll take B, please.
All right, B says, on this date in 1957, John Daring became the first man ever to cross a doctor's picket line. On that same date, Mr. Daring also became the first man ever to have a blank shoved up his nose.
What picket kind of picket line?
Doctors. All right. On this date in 1957, John Daring became the first man ever to cross a doctor's picket line. On that same date, Mr. Daring also became the first man ever to have a blank shoved up his nose.
A stethoscope.
A stethoscope. Good answer. Not bad, right?
I might have blown it with a Russell, but I came up with a stethoscope, Norma. There
right.
There we go.
If you need a clarification on a question like Bill Russell, I can do that. That's legal.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
What do you say?
I say, let's get out of here, hon. Go to Encino, get those colored lights going and the music. No? Well, what about stethoscope?
Hey, good. Wonderful. Three for her. What do you got, Sharon?
How can you get a stethoscope up any nose? I said thermometer.
Well, that's the whole idea. It was painful. McLean?
Oh.
I said a picture of Lou Russell and a proctoscope.
All right.
A picture of Lou Russell and a proctoscope.
Yeah. All right, Edie.
Do you remember that scene? You remember that scene
they don't know
in Chinatown?
What it is. In Chinatown?
You remember that scene when a Roman Polanski came up to Jack Nicholson and said, you're so smart, you boy, and then he went like that in his nose with a big scalpel knife.
Oh, yeah, right.
Painful.
Oh, that hurt, right.
Yeah.
All right, now, Art, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Some things just don't make sense. Like getting a job as a social director at a blank. All right, how are you doing?
Well, we're not.
You're all doing very well, extremely well. Chuck, you ready? All right, some things just don't make sense, like getting a job as a social director at a blank.
VD Clinic.
Listen, social director of
I know you're not going to win with that answer, but I admire your spunk in getting it. That's like carrying coals to Hollywood Boulevard.
That's right.
I got getting down to earth prison.
Prison, yeah, that's a reasonable answer. What do you say?
Oh, it's your local loony bin.
The local loony bin. And you, sir?
A funeral home.
A funeral home. All good responses there. I love yours, Art. I think that's nifty. Like getting a job as a social director at an...
an orgy.
An orgy. Oh, you don't need a social director.
I love that.
All right, Norma wins the game. What do you got there?
I said a funeral home.
Funeral home all the way. We're going to say goodbye to Art Haberman here, but he's not going empty-handed because he's got $250.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Art. Here's a little message for America.
Here again, the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go with Marvel, the Big Money Superman. He called the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Crocodile blank. All right, let's see who's going to offer a little assistance here.
Brett.
Crocodile tears.
Charles.
Well, honey, they said speed up.
Crocodile shoes and bag.
All right.
And McLean.
Now, what did Charles say?
Shoes.
Crocodile shoes.
Okay. Then I'm going to say crocodile bag.
Bag. Or purse. You can say purse. Don't
okay,
be afraid.
Okay, I'll say purse.
Nothing.
A crocodile purse bag.
All right.
And a picture of Lou Russell.
Yeah. Right.
So you've got tears, shoes, and bag. You want one of those or one of your own?
I'll go with crocodile tears.
All right, that's what you want. Let's take a look at the $100 response. Crocodile bag is McLean's answer. The next one says, crocodile rock, whatever that means. Now the top one reads, tears. You're this close to the wheel. Why don't we stand right here and have a go at it? Now, this is going to determine whether you play for $5,000 or for $10,000. Give it a spin and good luck to you. Here we go. Face me, please.
Wish I were dead.
All right.
No, you're good at this.
This is it. No help from the audience, please. Who blank? That's W-H-O blank. Do you understand? There we go.
I do indeed.
Who all right.
Blank. Oh, boy. The die... is cast.
All right, Bill is ready. That means you have to match him now. What do you say to that?
I say, who done it?
Who done it? Popular name for detective stories. Bill, who done it?
I don't know who done it, I had Who Cares.
Yeah.
Sorry, Norma.
Who cares? Well, they're both good responses, I think. I'm glad she's not walking out of here empty-handed. She's got $250, and we've got this message. She's got $500. Right. We've got this message for you. Raymond, goodbye.
Today's contestants will also... A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. The program was edited for broadcast.